Hello, and a very warm welcome from the Northern Parishes of Dartmoor for today's online service. Throughout this last month, during its short season, we have explored various aspects of Creationtide. Originally, a specific season for Creationtide was an Eastern Orthodox initiative, but it has now spread widely amongst the Protestant, Roman Catholic and Anglican congregations, and it brings Christians the world over together to pray and to work for the protection of the environment that sustains everyone. The psalm that is set for today is 146, and it tells us that our hope and faith should be in God because of his mighty works. God is the creator of heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them. God keeps faith forever and provides for all our needs. While we cannot see God, we can experience his presence just by walking outside and taking a deep breath of fresh air. God's creative majesty is all around us, especially those of us lucky enough to live in this beautiful part of Devon. A creator God is also a protector and provider of all the things we need to get through life, even when times are tough. And this summer has seen a huge challenge to what God created, from the widespread drought and its accompanying risk of fire and long-term damage to crops, livestock, and the natural world. One person who knew a thing or two about the importance of preserving creation was Her Late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. As you may well know, she initiated the Queen's Green Canopy, the planting of trees worldwide to celebrate her wonderful Platinum Jubilee. Many of our towns and villages here on the edge of Dartmoor will have trees planted to mark this. And the initiative even goes under the sea, as Plymouth's kelp forest is part of it. By contrast, outside the Anglican Church of St. Philip in Narrow Moru in central Kenya stands a Brazilian rosewood tree. This was probably the last tree that Her Majesty planted as a princess, as she did so just days before she became queen. Today, at more than 70 years old and soaring into the sky, it's an endearing symbol of the Queen's long reign. Surely a wonderful legacy to commemorate Her Majesty's life and service, and living proof of her contribution towards maintaining God's creation. But let us now start our service with a moment of silence and a prayer based on Psalm 146. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will sing praises to God all my life long. Happy are those whose help is in God, creator of heaven and earth, who is forever faithful, seeking justice for the oppressed and for the hungry, setting prisoners free and opening the eyes of the blind, lifting up those who are bowed down and loving the righteous. The Lord protects strangers and upholds the orphan and widow, but the way of the wicked is brought to ruin. The Lord our God will reign forever for all generations. Praise the Lord. Amen. We will now have today's first hymn. prayer of confession, once again based on Psalm 146. With our whole being, we bring our praise before you, our holy God. Made in your image, we find comfort in being called your children. But in our complacency, we can sometimes forget that this is not our own doing. Even as you have lifted us up, you call us to lift ourselves up. God, the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, forgive us when we dishonour your creation. Forgive us when we are weak. Forgive us when we turn a blind eye to injustice or when our voices remain silent. Forgive us when we are satisfied with our full stomachs rather than unsatisfied that others remain empty. Forgive us when we are blinkered and lead others astray. Forgive us when we deny our part in systems of injustice. Forgive our self-righteousness. Forgive us when we fail to consider those who are displaced and do not offer a hand. In silence, we pray. Amen. Let us now have today's readings.
A reading from the first letter of Timothy, chapter 6, beginning at verse 6. Of course, there is great gain in godliness combined with contentment, for we brought nothing into the world, so that we can take nothing out of it. But if we had food and clothing, we would be content with these. But those who want to be rich fall into temptation and are trapped by many senseless and harmful desires that purge people into ruin and destruction. For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil, and in their eagerness to be rich, some have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many pains. But as for you, man of God, shun all this, pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, gentleness. Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called and for which you have made the good confession in the presence of many witnesses, in the presence of God, who gives life to all things, and of Christ Jesus, who in his testimony before Pontius Pilate made the good confession. I charge you to keep the commandment without spot or blame until the manifestation of our Lord Jesus Christ, which will bring about at the right time. For he is who is the blessed and only sovereign, the King of kings and Lord of lords. It is he alone who has immortality and dwells in unapproachable light, whom no one has ever seen or can see. To him be honour and eternal dominion. Amen. As for those who in the present age are rich, command them not to be haughty, or to set their hopes on the uncertainty of riches, or rather on God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. They are to do good, to be rich in good works, generous and ready to share, thus storing up for themselves the treasure of a good foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of the life that really is life. This is the word of the Lord.
Reading from Luke 16. There was a rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen and who feasted sumptuously every day. And at his gate was laid a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who desired to be fed with what fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, even the dogs came and licked his sores. The poor man died and is carried by the angels to Abraham's side. The rich man also died and was buried. And in Hades, being in torment, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. And he called out, "Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus to dip the end of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am in anguish in this flame." But Abraham said, Child, remember that you in your lifetime received good things, and Lazarus, in like manner, bad things. But now he is comforted here, and you are in anguish. And besides all this, between us and you a great chasm has been fixed, in order that those who would pass from here to you may not be able, and none may cross from there to us. And he said, Then I beg you, Father Abraham, to send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that he may warn them, lest they also come into this place of torment. But Abraham said, They have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. And he said, No, Father Abraham, but if someone goes to them from the dead, they will repent. He said to him, If they do not hear Moses and the prophets, neither will they be convinced if someone should rise from the dead. Amen.
Are God's concerns. Let us pray to him now. In these times of change, we pray for our royal family, our political leaders, and our country. Guide and strengthen and comfort, we pray, our new king as he takes over from his mother, our late queen, a hard act indeed to follow. May our new political leaders come to realise the value of long-term planning. And may they govern for the common good and never for personal gain. Lord, bless our small island, its beauty, diversity and heritage. We thank you for your generosity in its creation and ask that you will make us good and worthy stewards. Amen. In this period of Creationtide, we offer a prayer from the Iona community. O God, creator of all that is, of seas and clouds, rain and rivers, grass and trees, insects and fish, humans, animals, birds and reptiles, of all life connected, sharing this one earth. We are aware that our way of living is profoundly affecting the earth's climate and that many people are in danger of flood or drought, that some are greatly impoverished, and the whole fabric of life is in danger. To those who make international policies, give wisdom and courage. To those who direct industry and commerce, give a concern for the common good. To those who struggle for justice, give strength and hope. and to us all, give the grace to change our ways for the good of all that lives and for your glory. Amen. Lord, in a moment of silence, we bring to you those we know who are ill or suffering in any way. Give them healing, restore them in body, mind, and spirit, and walk with them. And Father, we call to mind those who have died, and particularly those we have known and loved. Thank you for them. Surround them with your love. And we continue to hold in our prayers the members of the late Queen's family. Amen. And we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you so much for joining us for our service today. Please continue to hold in your prayers James Greer as he is ordained as the new Bishop of Plymouth at a service at Westminster Abbey on Thursday. As we lead on into through and throughout autumn, May you be blessed with a season of mellow fruitfulness. And once more, I will use prayers and words from Psalm 146 as our final blessing. Dear God, today we ask you to grant us strength to do as you please, wisdom to discern your best for us, compassion to serve others who need you, power to overcome the world's temptations. It is in you we trust. It is you who saves us. Bless us and keep us faithful as you are faithful to us from one generation to the next. Amen. Please stay safe this week, and we do hope that you will join us again very soon. Goodbye.